Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to convert decimal number to binary number Python. So let's get started. So first let me explain you what is the normal way of converting it, and after that we need to convert that normal way into our code. So let me just take an example number as 14. So what we will do is we'll be basically like dividing this number by 2 and we will be just storing the remainder. So to convert 14 to its binary form, we'll just have like this 14. And as I told you, we will divide it by 2 and we will just store the remainder. So 14 divided by 2 will give us the remainder as 0. And after this step, we will find the quotient of 14 divided by 2, which is 7. Then we will find the remainder of 7, which is 1. After that, we will be finding the quotient. And after this, we will be finding the remainder, which is 1. After this, quotient 1. And here it's going to be remainder is 1 in this case also, and after this the quotient will be 0. So this is the step. Actually we will be finding remainder and quotient alternatively, starting with the remainder at first. So it's remainder, then quotient, remainder, then quotient. So this step is followed till that number becomes 0. Okay, so we will be doing this exact same thing in our program. So let's jump into it. So first thing, we will be getting a number as an input from the user. So it's going to be n equal to int of input enter number. Yeah, you need to have it as int. And another important thing what we will do here is that we will be storing this, okay? We need to store this number at the end. So I will also show you how to store this number. I'll be using a string and later I'll be converting into an integer while storing this number. You can do it in a form of array also, it's up to you. So this is the first step, and as I told you, we'll be having a while loop so that we can repeatedly do this particular step. So this is like a continuous process, right? Like we need to find remainder, quotient in a cycle. So for that we can use a while loop, and our condition is going to be here we stop the program when the number was 0. So our condition here is going to be number greater than 0. So if the number is less than 0, the while loop breaks. So the first step, as I told you, we begin with finding the remainder. So it's going to be remainder equal to number modulus of 2. So the modulus operator returns the remainder. And next thing what we need to do, after finding the remainder, we need to find a way to store this remainder, okay? So for that, as I told you, here I will be using a string variable. So let s equal to be my empty string at first, and here s equal to r plus s. So I'm just trying to like store the integer value, that is the remainder, to the string s, like append it to the string. Okay, it's not like adding, we are not performing addition operation over here, we are just like appending. So it's like this is considered this as an like character or something. So it's going to be like I plus I something, like it's going to be two i's like this. But the issue is that this is an integer. Our r, which is our remainder, is an integer. So we need to convert this r to string first, and then only we can like add it with our remaining or empty string. So it's going to be str of r. Yeah. So how this works is that, so at first our, take this example, it's 14, right? So at first our remainder is 0. So it's going to be, this is going to be a string, okay? Because we are having this condition of str of r. So it's going to be plus empty string, so this is going to be 0, and after that, during the next iteration, r is going to be 1, so it's going to be string 1 plus the existing string was 0. So you can say that 0 is our existing string, so it's going to be like this, and this will be equal to 1 0. Okay, so this is how it works, and at the end, this will be a string with value 1 1 1 0, which corresponds to the number 14, and we will be converting this to integer if you want. So this is how it works in a nutshell. So after storing the number, the next thing what we did is we found the quotient. Like basically we converted the number itself to its quotient when divided by 2. So we'll be having here number equal to number double slash 2. We need to put double slash. If we put single slash, we will be getting a float or decimal number. So to avoid that, put double slash 2. So that's the code basically. Yeah, that's the code. And if I just now go and print, we'll be printing the string s. Yeah, and if I save it and run it, If I put 14, we need to get 1110. Yeah, that's fine. And if you want to convert this to an integer number, you can just put int of the number. Yeah. And if I go with, what can I go? I can go with 25. Yeah. So it's going to be 1. 2 is 0, 4 is 0. So it's 1 plus 8 plus 16, which is 16 plus 9, which is 25. So this works. And if you want, I can just print and show you how this code works in each and every step. So it's going to be print. I'll just print yes here, like in between. And if I just now save it, run it, and let me go with for 14. Yeah, so this is how it works. Initially, here you can see it, this exact same thing. Yeah, it's 0, then we're having 10, and we're having 210, and we're having 1110. Exactly how it works, and we are getting an additional 1110 because of this another extra print statement that we have at the end. So that's the reason why we are getting that twice. So this is the code, guys, and if you have any other better way of finding it, you can just let me know in the comments below, and do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many tutorials in Python, C, C++, Java, MySQL, MongoDB, Node.js, Spring Boot, CRUD operations. So check them, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.